Friday and Saturday night crowd because the weekend, but also I get worried that you might regret doing your weekend, so I was getting very nervous at the weekend show, so I'm glad you're having a good time. I can't see you very well right now, but after this next song, these weird walls go up and I can see you again a bit. Nice to see some of your faces, because when I come up here at the beginning of the show to do hello, I'm literally a bag of nerves and I'm shitting myself, so I don't think I'm kind of hard to. But my nerves are going now. But this next one, I always get very sentimental and nostalgic and quite emotional whenever I sing this song in America. And I wrote it in a kind of damp basement in West London almost 10 years ago, so I don't know quite why I kind of feel so deeply about this song here, but I think it's because when I came here, my music with my first album, this was the song that was kind of leading my first album. And I went around a lot doing radio shows and stuff like that, and a lot of the time no one would ever turn up to the radio gigs that I was doing, and anyone that did just came for the free pizza or the free pancakes, and then they'd take it and they'd go. But I did a few things like that, and I 100% think you should have to work very hard for anything good that you achieve. But there were times I don't know if there's any point in me doing this. I don't think it's going to happen here. Maybe how many times should I come and do this? And just because people from England and Britain and stuff, it's very rare that we end up cracking America, as what we call it. And even when I signed my American record deal, I just thought it was like the biggest blag of all time. I was like, yeah, cool, I'll come back and forth. It's a free holiday. Yeah, of course I come and do it. Never in my wildest dreams did I think that, you know, going from doing those radio shows when no one came to then being able to do two nights here in Philly. You know, there were lots of times where I was, you know, disconnected from it here and stuff like that. And although I know that I did garner some loyal fans with my first album and stuff like that, it felt like a typical rock album. And I would come and go, like I said, and then I got SNL, so I went to New York to do SNL. Because in England, we're not on the same page or something, so we don't have the NFL, like we don't have American football in England. We get confused when you call that football because we call soccer football, you know, stuff like that. Tomato and tomato, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, so I didn't know what it was, but I did know who Tina Fey was, and she was on the show. So I was very excited. And then I realised there was a lot of drama going on at the show because it was a presidential campaign, so it's almost like 7 years to the dot, I think, isn't it, really, because it's a presidential campaign again. But anyway, so I got very nervous before I went on because I realised it felt like everyone was watching. So I did this song and I went to the cold shoulder. And when I went home the next day, I've got a few 19ers over there now. And I went home, and then when I landed, it was like it had taken off in America a bit, but by that point, very shortly after that, I turned 21, and that was when shit got real with my girlfriend. Oh my God. So I was like, I can't actually stay here. I need to go home and write a fucking record because it's kind of I'll go. So I actually didn't hang around that long after this next song started to take off. So I went home and then I wrote an album, and I do believe, and I could be wrong, but I will always believe this, that the reason that people were so open-armed to the 21 album was because people had decided to allow themselves to connect to this song that I'm going to do for you. Like I said, I could be wrong. And this song is very